But if you close your eyes.
What is up, guys? I am Warpath, and today we are back again, and we're going to be doing a Heroes of the Storm 2.0 review. And in this video, I kind of just want to go over some of the stuff that I feel Blizzard has done, some of the good things that I've seen them do, and just talk about the state of the game and kind of the health of it as well, compared to what it was before, and compared to some other things as well. So first off, I just want to start off by saying thank you all of you for coming today and watching this video. It means a lot to me. If you guys are new, remember to subscribe, hit the like button if you guys like it, dislike button if you guys dislike it. Anyways, let's go ahead and get right into this here. So the first thing I want to start off doing is starting to talk about the good and the bad of the game currently, of 2.0. And really, in all honesty, Blizzard didn't make that much of a change. They kind of added a couple things, there was some new stuff going on, but in general, it was mostly Blizzard just giving us a bunch of free stuff and being like, hey, check it out again, it's pretty cool. And they were right, it is pretty cool. But anyways, so some of the good stuff that's going on right now in the game, these are things that make the game kind of what it is. They kind of define the game and they really set it apart from a lot of other things. And one of the big things about it is the fact that the matches in this game are extremely short. Which kind of falls into both categories, but I put it in the pro category, the good category, because I think this is crucial to the way the game is. It makes it so that these matches are extremely action-packed. They're you know, all kind of bundled into this 15, 20, 25 minute game. And it allows for a lot of really cool things to happen. So the fact that they are short matches, I think, is actually a good thing. The other thing is it's very easy to learn and quick to pick up. So what I mean by this is because of the fact that there aren't tons and tons of items and several different things for several different styles of play, like there's no attack damage or ability power or tank, or, you know, there aren't all these like subcategories of heroes. While there are, each hero only has a different build path per hero, so it just makes it super easy to learn and pick up, and I think that's really important for this game in general. Again, this can kind of fall in the con category or the bad category, and we'll talk again about this a little bit later once we get to that. But one of the other really amazing things that Blizzard has going for it with this game is the fact that its characters are lovable and well-known. Each and every character is amazing. You know, who doesn't want to play as Arthas? Who doesn't want to play as Illidan? Or, you know, who doesn't want to play as any of the StarCraft heroes? I mean, it's just an amazing, it's an amazing environment for what they have. And I'm really glad to see that this game is hopefully, you know, taken off a little bit again. You know, because I do like it. I do think it's a cool game. And the other thing is, I think they have some really cool, unique character designs. They have some really awesome mechanics in the game that other games of the same similar style don't have. And I think Blizzard has done a really good job of that, and I hope to continue seeing them do this sort of thing with the characters. So that kind of takes me into the negative side of things here. One of the big things we talked about in the pros is the fact that it's easy to learn. It's very simple. And that actually does fall into the negative category as well, because it is oversimplified. They've taken a lot of things out of the MOBA genre. And I know, guys, it's not classified as a MOBA. It's classified as a hero brawler. But we'll talk about that in just a second, too. But basically, they've taken a lot of stuff out of the game that used to be in other games, or, you know, they've just simplified it down, and I feel as though they may have done too much. Now, this kind of brings me to one of the big points of this video. It's why did Heroes of the Storm originally kind of tank or fall off, or, you know, why did it have a bad streak there? And honestly, I think it is because of this one big con. It's this lack of depth that the game seems to have, and I can't quite put my finger on what it is exactly, but it's definitely there, and I feel as most people kind of know that and understand that. So I don't know. I want to know ways that maybe Blizzard could improve upon this, or I've got a couple ideas myself, but I'd love to hear from you guys what you guys think about it too. In the negative side of things, I want to talk about the fact that while they don't classify themselves as a MOBA, they are directly competing against two massive MOBAs. I mean, they have two mega giant MOBAs that they're competing with, and that's League and Dota 2. Whether they want to say they are or not, they are. I mean, that's just the truth of it. People who are interested in this game play both of those games. That's the way it is. That's their competition. Whether they accept it or not, it is what it is. I think they need to address that fact. While it may be a hero brawler in their eyes, it's definitely a MOBA in pretty much everyone else's eyes. So this kind of leads me to my next thing. I want to talk about some of the ideas I have for improvement for the game. I kind of want to see maybe what we can do to kind of make the game better, even from here. I think one of the coolest things that they could do is adding a buff objective of some sort to the game. Maybe do it on a new map or something, add it to existing maps. I don't know, I think it'd be really cool to kind of change the dynamic of the game. But, I mean, think about this. It's in both, it's in both League of Legends and Dota 2, where they have objectives that basically give them buffs or, you know, even temporary buffs, whole game buffs, you know, depending on what it is. But I think it would be really cool to add this so that teams sometimes have to make a decision between whether or not they want to, go for a buff objective over, like, the actual game objective. It would just add another layer of depth to the game, and that's really what this game needs. And the other thing I thought of too was perhaps adding like new maps where the games actually do last longer, because in these maps, basically it would open up the opportunity for some of the really late game characters that don't take off, and some of the really late game builds that don't take off until, you know, you're 20 minutes into the game, you're level 20, and you know, it would open up the game to a lot of that as well. So I think that's a really cool idea that they could probably explore a little bit more in the future. And some improvements that they actually have made from the original quote-unquote Heroes of the Storm, they've pretty much just added more loot to the game. So they've added more ways to get gold, more ways to get characters and heroes, and more ways to get skins. And I think that's a brilliant idea. It brings people back, kind of gets people into the game, and you know what's going to happen? We're probably going to end up spending money on it, so good on them. It was a good call. They did a good job. They've also added stimpack bonuses so people can level up and get gold faster, and they've incentivized playing the game, which is really important. So they did a great job, I think, with this update. Now, is Heroes of the Storm better? Is it good? Well, I definitely think it's better. From what it was, they did a really good job of improving the game. They added new characters, new maps. They've incentivized the game, like I said. So they have definitely improved a game state. Is it good enough to take off? I don't know. I hope so. I like the game, but I'm just not sure. So we'll see where it goes, but that's kind of my thoughts on that. Now, some of the other issues that I want to kind of address here. We're going to be talking about the fact that this is kind of where I think the lack of depth comes from in the game. And maybe you guys can expand more on this, but this is what I think. So currently, players cannot really get fed. An individual player cannot get fed. Only the teams can get fed. So when a team gets ahead, they have an experience advantage, a level advantage, and therefore a power advantage over the enemy team. And that's what I mean by teams can get fed, but not individual players. Now, this is good because it promotes team play, but it's also bad because it takes away from individual skill. So one person can't snowball the entire game and completely carry an entire game by itself. However, that also takes that out of the game. So while it decreases the depth, it also makes the game, in my opinion, a little bit nicer to play than League of Legends and Dota 2, where people can snowball out of control and just, you know what I mean. You guys have played the games before, probably, and that's kind of my thoughts on that. So as always, guys, let me know what you guys think about all this. That is going to be it for today's video. I hope you guys did enjoy this. If you did, remember to hit the like button and subscribe, guys. Thank you all for coming and hanging out with me. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Seriously, I want to know. But enjoy the rest of this clip, guys. Have a good rest of your day, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.
How am I gonna be an optimist about this? How am I gonna be an optimist about this?